Since their modern classification in the early 20th century, we have classified countless galaxies both near and distant from our own. Despite such an abundance of galaxies to observe, understanding how they have formed and evolved over time is still an area of astronomy with many unanswered questions. Tracing the formation history of a galaxy is complicated. Over its lifetime, it'll be shaped by a number of factors, including the mass of its constituent stars, the rate at which new stars are being produced, gas and dark matter in the galaxy at a particular time, its environment, and the interactions with neighboring galaxies. To address this, astronomers need to observe statistically large samples of galaxies, collectively known as a galaxy survey. Traditionally, these surveys, such as SDSS and Gamma, consisted of measuring a single spectrum for hundreds of thousands of galaxies. And while these surveys provide lots of information about the properties of galaxies, some information, such as the dynamics of stars and gas, can only be ascertained by measuring the spectra of different spatial positions of the galaxy. An integral field unit, or IFU spectrograph, is used to achieve this. The SAMI survey makes use of the SAMI instrument with multiple IFU spectrographs to answer these questions. The SAMI instrument can observe up to 61 spectra at different spatial positions in a single galaxy, while observing 12 galaxies at the same time, compared with traditional single-fiber spectroscopy. This makes the SAMI instrument efficient at collecting spatially resolved spectra. Due to SAMI's instrument's capability of observing 12 galaxies simultaneously, the SAMI survey proposed to observe 3,400 galaxies, an order of magnitude more galaxies than predecessor IFU surveys. For any large survey, astronomers have to decide which galaxies should be observed to achieve the signs in question. In order to understand the relative importance of these different processes contributing to a galaxy's formation and evolution, as in SAMI, astronomers must define a largely unbiased population that covers a broad range of galaxy types, as defined by their stellar mass, over a range of different environments. Galaxies at different stellar masses are thought to have formed through vastly different evolutionary paths, with the environment shaping these different galaxies to varying degrees. Therefore, by targeting galaxies over a range of stellar masses and environments, the SAMI Galaxy Survey can determine how these factors have driven its evolution. In order for SAMI to target galaxies over a range of masses and environments, we must already know the properties of a large number of galaxies and where they reside in the universe. Fortunately, a previous survey conducted at the Anglo-Australian Telescope, the AAT, has already conducted the bulk of measurements necessary for building an input catalogue for the SAMI survey. The Galaxy and Mass Assembly, or GAMMA survey, measured the properties and positions of approximately 250,000 galaxies, allowing a detailed parameterization of their stellar mass and environments. The SAMI selection only observed a brighter subset of the GAMMA sample, but despite the high completeness of the GAMMA survey, it does not include galaxies in the densest environments, clusters, large gravitationally bound galactic structures in the universe. To combat this, the SAMI survey has been augmented with additional galaxies from 8 dense clusters specially chosen for the SAMI survey. The resulting targets cover the entire range of galaxy environments that have been detected in the local universe. The first observations occurred in March 2013, using the SAMI instrument in conjunction with the AA Omega spectrograph at the Anglo-Australian Telescope. Once the SAMI data is collected, it goes through a data reduction process which transforms the raw data from the telescope into calibrated information that can be scientifically analysed. The aim of data reduction is to remove unwanted signal, such as emission from the Earth's atmosphere and distortions in the instrument from the galaxy spectra. The following overview demonstrates the basic process used for integral field spectrographs, such as a SAMI instrument. The relevant packages that are used to achieve this can be downloaded via the links in the description box below this video. The first steps involve removing signals produced by the CCD camera itself, which will vary depending on the manufacturing characteristics of the camera. The two main processes are the removal of the bias level and the dark current. The bias level is a resulting signal from the readout electronics of the camera and is measured via a close to zero length exposure with the shutter closed. The dark current is signal that accumulates in the CCD over time, even if the shutter is closed. Therefore, like the bias frame, the dark frame is taken with a shutter closed, but over a long exposure time. The bias level and the dark current are then subtracted from all of the other data to remove these unwanted signals. The next steps remove variations in sensitivity between different elements of each path of the instrument. These steps are generally referred to as flat fields. The first flat field calibration, the detector flat, measures variations in the sensitivity of the individual pixels of the CCD, using a uniform illumination of the entire camera. The second flat field calibration is known as a fiber flat, and removes differences in the transmission between individual fibers of the integral field unit. Fiber flats require the telescope to be illuminated with a uniform surface. Therefore, astronomers will either use the sky itself at twilight, or a specially painted and illuminated surface inside the telescope dome. Science data is then divided by the detector flat and the fiber flat calibrations to correct for any sensitivity variations. For spectroscopy using fiber optics, another important calibration is a tramline map. The spectrograph spreads the light from each fiber into a spectrum that stretches across the camera image in one direction. Additional fibers are stacked above and below so that each spectrum occupies its own narrow strip of the image between its neighbors. The tramline map shows where each spectrum is within the overall image. It is calibrated by tracing the light from each fiber across the same image used for the fiber flat. The tramline map is then used by powerful software to find and extract from each CCD image all of the light collected for each spectrum, while also rejecting any contaminating light from neighboring spectra. When using a spectrograph, it is important to calibrate the wavelength scale of the spectra. For SAMI, this is achieved by passing the light from a copper-argon lamp through the spectrograph. Copper-argon, when heated, emits light at thousands of wavelengths, which are known from our theoretical understanding of atoms. When passed through the spectrograph, these illuminated wavelengths act as markers and can be used to calibrate a full wavelength scale of the spectrograph. The final calibration steps involve removing signal introduced by the Earth's atmosphere. These steps are sky subtraction, toluic correction, and spectrophotometric or flux calibration. Sky subtraction removes signal from the Earth's atmosphere, which glows slightly, even at night. The toluic correction removes absorption of light in the red arm of the AO Omega spectrograph, caused by water vapor in the atmosphere. Finally, the data from multiple observations of the same target are assembled together in a spectral cube. The spectral cube can be thought of as a one-dimensional array of images of the galaxy at each wavelength, or as a two-dimensional map of spectra across the galaxy. Making the cube itself is a complex process, where the main step involves converting the observed photon count for each pixel to a flux value that can be used for scientific analysis. Once the calibrations are complete and formatted into a spectral cube, it is time to start doing some science on the galaxies. Aside from calculating the flux for each pixel wavelength into the spectral cube, several other data products are usually calculated to assist in the scientific analysis.
So for each SAMI galaxy, we have an image that comes from the selection survey that was used to choose that galaxy. For example, an SDSS image. Then the SAMI instrument itself produces from the 3D cube a continuum flux image, which is measuring the intensity of the stars in the galaxy. A stellar velocity image, in which the red regions are rotating away from us and the blue regions are rotating towards us. So that shows the motion of the stars. Then the H-alpha gas image. H-alpha gas traces where gas is in the galaxy because that gas is ionized by stars and re-emits in the H-alpha emission line. Then by measuring the shift of that line from where it nominally should be, we can measure the velocity of that gas. Again, with the red rotating away from us and the blue rotating towards us. In this particular galaxy, the gas and the stars are actually rotating together and around the same axis. In some galaxies, that's not actually the case. But taking both the stellar velocities and the gas velocities, and also being able to measure higher order moments, which tell us some of the detailed kinematics in both the stars and the gas, and combining that with the flux from the continuum and the flux from the gas, we can deduce an awful lot of information about how gas gets into and out of galaxies, and how that gas then forms stars. And this is crucial to our understanding of the build-up of mass in galaxies and how galaxies evolve over time to look like the different types of morphologies, shapes, and dynamics that we see in the universe around us today.
The original spectral cubes and the value-added products are uploaded onto the Australian Astronomical Observatory's archive, Data Central. This is a public online data analysis sharing system available to astronomers around the world. It consists of optical astronomical data of significance to Australian astronomers and makes accessing archived and current survey data easier and more readily available for all astronomers. SAMI is an ambitious and innovative project that has aimed to answer some of the most daring questions in galaxy evolution. From early results, astronomers have found interesting features that are telling us more about galaxies and, of course, introducing more questions. With the next generation projects already in motion, multi-object integral field spectroscopy has only begun to scratch the surface in galaxy evolution research.